Welcome back to American Trucking Simulator with the Rude Man. And we're going to take a look, before we take a job today, at our profile and see how things are going with the business. Not the profile, the company manager. Take a look at the drivers first. And first we'll start off with me. I'm one of the drivers. I'm up to 1.7. Level 5, I think I am. I have the explosive placard, so I can haul explosives. The next one will be for gases, fuels, that kind of thing. I do have two in long haul. I have one in high price cargo and one in fragile. And so, yeah, I'm doing okay. Let's take a look at our other driver. Mr. Merrick, he's at 0.08. He's got one in long haul, one in high value, and one in fragile, and one in just on time. Now, normally, these guys come where they're set up at balanced, and then it randomly puts things into when they level up. It randomly puts these in. I like to control it myself. Think of it this way. Let's take a look at your long distance. If you drive a longer distance, wouldn't you think you'd make more money? Because obviously you're spending more time on the road and using fuel and everything else. So I'm of the opinion that the long distance is going to make sure that I have the ability to make more money if I choose to take one that's a longer distance. That would be my choice. If I don't put anything in here, I'm not even going to get that choice because it's going to say, hey, you don't have the experience to do long distances. So that's where I start off right away, is putting them in long distance. And then I work between the high item values and the fragile items, because again, that opens up those kinds of jobs for you. I recently took a job where I was hauling automobiles. You won't get that if you don't have any experience in the high value. So again, that just opens up your choices as to what kind of jobs you can get. The next thing you want to start doing after you get a couple of these built up is to get up into these placards. Again, if you think about it, let's say you've got 5 jobs available and 3 of them are tankers. Well, if you don't have a placard to haul any tankers, you don't even get a chance at those jobs. You've only got a chance at the other two. If the tanker jobs were the ones that paid the most, you've just messed yourself out of some pay. So I like to kind of play with these myself and get these guys trained up the way I want to. This one is economy for the ecology. With this, you get better gas mileages and things like that. I don't bother with that right away. I may later on. That doesn't really make any difference to me as far as the start of the game, because at the start of the game, I want to make as much money as I can. I want to increase the size of my garage. I want to hire drivers. I want to buy trucks. That means I need higher paying jobs. I don't care if I get good gas mileage or not. As far as I can tell, this one isn't going to make me any money at all outside of saving me some fuel costs. So that's why I don't bother with that right away, if at all. Okay, so let's get out of here. Let's go see if we can find a job. First of all, I need to make sure if I need to rest first. And it looks like I do. I'm just dead tired. So let's start the truck up and let's fetch on out of here. And it looks like we've got fuel just around the corner. And we also have some place to rest just around the corner, I think. Let's see. So we're going to deadhead over, get us some fuel, take care of that before we take a job. I did kick the possibility of some weather in. I think I bumped it up to about 20, 30, I can't remember. Something like that. So we may get some weather. How'd you like my California stop there? So anyway, yeah, I know, we're getting tired. We'll take care of that in just a second. We're gonna get some fuel first. And we're running out of fuel. Well, it's just telling me everything. All right, let's fuel up. Maintenance. I did some changing of buttons around. I put the button that I had for the cruise control up on my steering wheel, which made more sense. And if you look at the dashboard, that right there in the middle there, the gauges, water, oil, temperature, that kind of thing, I set that up on the button that the cruise control was on, which was where it was in the first place. So, whoa. Good thing he stopped. Sorry. Yeah, I said I wasn't going to do that anymore. I'm going to take it nice and slow and easy and try to drive like a human being instead of foot to the floor type stuff. That's why I put the cruise control in, so I didn't do that kind of thing anymore. I'm driving it like it's a video game instead of like it's like real. So I know I'm getting tired. I'm going to sleep right up here at this motel. Give me a break. I'm working on it. I think I can sneak in the back way here. Well, they let you park right in this driveway. That's not very neighborly. Look, I'm holding up your driveway. Nobody else can come in. Now, this is where a truck, I think, would normally park, right here in this big long. Gives you enough room for your trailer. So that's what we're going to do. Get a good night's sleep. Okay, so it's morning. Let's go see if we can find a job. First of all, where do we need to go to look? Let me pull my cruise control. Where's that job I just came from? Was it down this way? Loan installment, another payment made. Yeah, it's down this way. Look at those old cars. This was where we dropped off the trailer. I'm driving like a wild man again. I need to straighten that out. Do what you said you were gonna do. Drive like a regular person. Like a wild man. I'm driving like it's Grand Theft Auto or something. All right, let's see if we can get a job here. Okay, home accessories, 26,000 pounds of home accessories. Whoa, that's heavy. All right, so we're going back to Reading. And there's the trailer right in front of us. Very good. Let's hook up to it. Don't hit that tanker. And this game is very forgiving when you hook up to a trailer. I could miss it by a mile and it'll still let me hook up to it. I like to try to make it look like at least I'm underneath it correctly. But you don't have to. I could be 3 feet off and it would still let you hook up to it. All right, we're off. All right, so we have home accessories, 26,000 pounds, so it's not real heavy. We're heading to Reading, and we're supposed to be there by Thursday at 3:51 in the morning at the latest. It is now around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. We have to sleep in 12 hours, 11 hours. And our estimated time of arrival is Wednesday at 11:30 p.m. So I'd like to do that because I don't want to get there at 3 o'clock in the morning. This is a lot lighter than the one load we had before. All right, so we're heading right here. I don't think that's through traffic. We shouldn't have to worry about hitting anybody. I don't want to hit anybody this early in the morning. And we're heading to the left. To the left, to the left, to the left, right, left. I don't see anybody. This is my kind of traffic. Motor City. Yes, I was talking about changing the weather. I think I can't verify it. I can if I want to go into the options. But I think that before I left the last episode, I went in and adjusted the weather to about 23 or 25%, something like that. So there's a 25% chance that it's going to rain. I don't think there's snow in the game. I had snow in the Euro Trucker, but that was only because I had a mod. That was fun because it changed the physics of the game so that you'd slide. And if you weren't careful, let's see, we're going right. If you weren't careful, you could really rack a truck up. Alright, let's see if we can get into traffic here without hitting anybody. Nice that guy staying in that lane over there. I know he did it just for us. See if our cruise control works with our new button. Appears to, but appearances can be deceiving. Whoa, stay on the road. Now, see, I was watching my GPS, and if you remember, you barely have to touch this wheel, and you're off in the next lane. It's part of the compressed distances and that kind of thing that make it more difficult to drive than it would be in real life. So yeah, we're not in a big hurry. Part of it also is I need a little bit of maintenance on the truck. The maintenance gets away from you. When you have maintenance that gets not taken care of, your steering gets off, it gets real kind of goofy. Things to your truck start to happen. Every once in a while your truck will die on you, and then it comes back on, and warning will come up and say, hey, you need maintenance on this rig. So you really need to maintain it. You should do it at least every other job, if not every job. Pull in and do a little maintenance. Your truck will show you that there's damage. Well, see, mine's showing 3%. I haven't hit anything in a while. And so it's not really damage. It's just normal wear. It will also show up as damage. So every once in a while, you need to pull into a shop and just do, you know, whatever it says to do. Now, there's some options that you can choose that, like, I didn't have one that's called something like more realistic fuel consumption. Well, I don't know what that would do. You already have fuel consumption. What else could they do to it? So I'm not quite sure what that would do. I didn't select it. I selected the weather. I just beefed up the weather, the chances of rain, which isn't real realistic from where we're, you know, where we're driving. California, Nevada, desert, doesn't rain all that much. If you remember, there's that silly song from the 70s, it never rains in Southern California. Actually, it does. San Francisco rains often, but you know, there are parts of California that just literally very seldom rains. So to beef up the rain isn't terribly realistic, but it might be kind of fun to have a little different weather. And I'd be interested to find out in this version of the game, the Euro Truck, all it did was add rain and maybe a little bit of fog. Didn't add snow. Like I say, I had to have a mod to do that. And it was an interesting mod. You had to really be careful. You slide right off the road. So let's see what else. Yeah, it'd be interesting to find out if it adds any other kind of weather. So far, I'm getting used to the cruise control. Keeps me out of trouble. Now, I just need to watch the speed. Speed will change kind of funny. All of a sudden, it'll just drop. Like, we're coming into a town, I expect it to drop, but I've had it in, you know, times where it dropped in crazy places. See, it keeps going between 30, 40, 55. Crazy. What's that all about? I'm also curious about one that I changed that had to do with the air brakes. I don't know what it did or what it does. Let's see. There's an option down here. Game preferences, I think it is. Rain probability. I got it up there as a ways. Online news, image spotlight, show cutscenes. I don't know what cutscenes it's going to show. Let's see. These are just English, whatever language you want to run in, that kind of thing. Air brake simulation, there's that one. Automatic engine and electric start, I don't know what that is. Yeah. So I don't know what air brake simulation does. There was the... You can turn the fatigue simulation off. Trailer stability. Now I don't know where the fuel thing is. I didn't see it. And I don't remember where I did see it. Oh well, doesn't matter. All right. Yes, I don't know what that air brake thing does really. I'm waiting for a green light. Come on. There we go. Weird, I thought I hit the cruise control. Oh, I moved the button. I've already forgotten. All right, I need to get behind this this guy here. Let me over. Let me over. I can't remember if the brakes made that sound before. Maybe that's what it does. I don't know. Too bad you can't use all those buttons on the steering wheel. That'd be cool. Is this going to be one of those that there's so much traffic you can't get out? I don't want to have to shut the game down again. That's a pain to have to do that. That's kind of an interesting color on that truck right there to the right, kind of a grayish. Come on, RV. Is there somebody in front of him? I bet there is. I'll bet there is. Oh, a truck. Come on. There he goes. And now we have a red light. Bummer trails. God, we're stacked up all the way to Kansas. And there's a donut shop. Come on, RV, get out there. Come on. Go, man, go. Just jump right out there. Oh, you missed the light. And then he goes on a red. That is not right. That is not right. You know that this UPS truck is going to turn to his left. You can pull in front of him. You know he's going to turn to the left. You don't sit at the stoplight like that and then go when it's red. It's green. You jump out there like this and come over and wait your turn. There's a repair shop, but I'm not going to take the time to go in it. I should have, but I'm anxious to get on the dang road. Got a freeway coming up here and another donut shop. What is that all about? All right, we're jumping on old I-5 here. I keep thinking this load's heavier than it is. Come on, give me a break. Give me a break. Let me in. I said I wasn't going to do that anymore. The problem with this game, though, is if you actually stop, like you're, you know, you'll never get out. It just doesn't give you a break. And I look down for just a second to make sure I hit the right shift button, and I'm off the road. That's what I'm talking about. You can't take your eyes off the road for a second. If you do and make any kind of little movement or the road curves just a tiny little bit, instantly you're off the highway. You gotta watch all the time. old eagle eye. Gotta keep your eagle eye out. Where did that saying come from? I'll keep an eye out for you. Is it somebody with a false eye that's watching out for you or what? I don't know. I don't understand that. It's 6 p.m. and it looks like it's getting dark already. Although it looks like it's clouding up, doesn't it? All right, we can kick this thing up now, I guess. See if we can get our speed up here. I'm in way too low a gear. Yeah, there's no happy medium there, is there? I need more gears. Actually, I don't. What the hell would I do with them? I can't hit the ones I already have. All right, we're kind of speeding. I don't know if I should. Like I say, this game, it's black and white. If you're doing 55, you're okay. If you're doing 56, you're in trouble. You're gonna get a ticket. Don't stop. Oh man, he slowed down just enough to get my momentum off. Yeah, look, it's getting dark skies, dark clouds there. It's going to rain. We're gonna get to use our windshield wipers for the first time in this game. What a cheesy horn. Doesn't that sound cheesy? Uh-oh, it's a speed trap. Not like we're speeding anywhere. Sun's going down at 7:30 p.m. What's that all about? Yeah, I'm gonna have to sleep here pretty soon. Vehicle inspection. I'm glad it tells you. One less thing to have to watch for. Now we need to stop and wait our turn. All right, now take it nice and slow. Normally, you'd go really, really slow and delicate. You don't want to mess the scales up. You don't want to cause any trouble. Okay, stop your truck and hit the appropriate icon. Thank you for your cooperation. No problemo. Glad to be of service. All the lights are kicking on at once like somebody just threw a switch. That's funny. Yeah, I need an extra gear in there someplace that I could miss. Look at those skies ahead. Think we're gonna hit any rain? Oh, somebody made $1,800. All right, let me get up to speed. Come on, let me get up to speed. Look, there's another policeman. Uh-oh, there's a train. has raced the train, he's going to win. And that's good. Let the train always win. Well, unless you're in the middle of the train track, then you don't want the train to win. And let's take a look at the map, see where we can sleep, because I'm going to be getting pretty darn sleepy. Oh my God, we got... Well, there's one right there. Let's see if we can make it. There is one thing that helps with the steering in the game, and that's if you keep a real light hand, and I think that actually helps you in real life too. These people that white knuckle it are not very well. They're kind of dangerous drivers, and so if you keep your hand real loose on the wheel, especially in this game, if you're gripping it, every little muscle twitch does something like this. You know, it's just, so you kind of hold it kind of loose and just kind of move it when it needs to be moved. And I think you're maybe better off. And it helps you stay a little bit calmer. If you grip the wheel, you're not, well, you're going to get fatigued if nothing else. Want to miss my turn again. Watch the GPS. Watch the watch. Okay, anything coming? Doesn't look like it. I think I'll be okay. Thank you for waiting. You're very kind. Turn signals don't always turn themselves off automatically like they should. I can't see. There we go. I hate to do that, but I need to be able to see. See if I can hit my sleeping facility before too long. I'm not in the red yet. Once you get in the red, you don't have a lot of time, though. Looks like we got something coming up right ahead here. Kinda. Oh, this is convenient. We'll take it right here. A parking lot, it says. All right. Good night. And we must have missed the rain. $798 my driver made. Good for him. Good for him. And back on the road we go. Over the sagebrush. Is that a bus behind me? Beautiful weather. Look at those blue skies and fluffy clouds. Oh, look, I didn't realize I was that close to the end. I'm at my destination and I stopped to sleep. Oh my gosh. Why didn't I see that? Oh, you see fishing from the bridge? Don't jump. All right, is this on the right or the left? Oh, it's on the right, I believe. We're in Reading already. Well, there you go. We made it, safe and sound. Wait a minute. What's this? This isn't right. Stop that. Is this our place? This might not be our place. No, it isn't. It isn't our place. Oh, what did I do? Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. This isn't our place. Oh, we turned too soon. I guess I did. Our place is over there. This is not your place. This is not the place you're looking for. There's a UPS guy, although it's not UPS in the game. I don't know what it is. This gives me the opportunity to find out, though. Is that a lunch wagon? UDS, United Delivery Service, and they're just... No, you don't see those guys just sitting around like that. All right, let's see if we can find where we're supposed to go. I think it's right around the corner here. Another donut shop. I never knew California's ate so many donuts. I thought they were all into healthy foods like rabbit food, stuff like that. I had no idea they ate that many donuts. Now we're at the right place. Okay, so it looks like we got kind of a normal backup. Except for they always put a trailer in the way. Look, there's a trailer up there right in the way. I'm gonna tuck in this way here. Pull in here as far as I can. Yeah, see, they always stick a trailer right there where you need to go. That's where I would normally go, is right where that trailer's at. But we'll still get it done. I just need to watch this right here. Right here. I need to get a little bit beyond this trailer before I can cut my rig. But we'll do it. We'll do it. We'll be fine. Might have cut it too far. I think I did. I think I did cut it too far. There, right there. All right, let's just straighten her up a little bit. Bring her on back. There we go. Bob's your uncle. Straight back now. And there it is. I'm late. I knew I shouldn't have slept. I should not have slept, but I didn't look at the map. Oh well, normally I'd have 2 or 3 tickets, so there you go. Oh, that's too bad. Well, we'll just have to be more careful next time. Alrighty, I'm gonna leave it at that, and we'll take another job in the next episode. Hopefully, let's take another look though. Where are we? Where's my, but I am level 5. I didn't make it to level 6, but we'll do that in the next episode. I want to make it to level 10 so I can do some upgrades on my truck. We'll get there. I may have to do a couple of jobs offline, try to get my level up a little bit. Hope you had fun. I hope you're having fun on your game, and I'll see you in the next episode. Happy truckin'.